something that is really percolating on social media today that that we want to play for you in just a second, because Dibs, it has a little something to do with the conversation that we were just having.
You know what that is, right?
The percolation sensation?
That's exactly what that is.
Or the conversation sensation.
Either I was thinking about the percolating, because you were talking about percolating, and I don't think you were talking about Kendrick percolating, so I thought we could get that out right away.
He'd been doing plenty of percolating the last couple of weeks. So anyway, it gave me feels that I didn't want to get, and it came from Anthony Edwards. And this is a stray, if you will. I got to kind of go around the bend to get to where I'm going, but all I can do is share with you how it felt to me when I heard it. So check this out. Anthony Edwards is sitting there getting ready for game 3. The Nuggets are transferring to Minnesota. The Timberwolves have a stranglehold on the series. For those of you who don't know, in the last round when Minnesota swept the Phoenix Suns, you got to move that monitor down. I need to see that beautiful full face of yours.
All right. We're going to read
what happened over there.
Well, yeah, seat's a little lower.
Yeah.
Guru's a tall man.
Put your seat up. I'm like, are you so light that you're just disappearing?
There we go.
Good Lord. Anyway, so in the last round against Minnesota or against Phoenix, Anthony Edwards talked about how, like, man, I look up to Kevin Durant. So this means a lot to me, this matchup, to go against Kevin Durant. Sam Amick, who is one of the top NBA reporters out there, gets into a conversation with him in terms of, like, is there anybody on the Denver Nuggets that sort of evokes that feeling for you? Here is the conversation.
Hey, you talked in that Phoenix series a lot about the way you saw Kevin and how that motivated you. And at your age, it's got to be fun to see all these OGs right in front of you. Is there anything like that in this series? Like, what's your...
Nah, these guys, 3-4 years older than me, man, yeah.
I mean, Jamal's been around for a minute. Is that a guy that you've been tracking at all?
Nah, hell nah. Like I said, what is he, 27? I'm gonna turn 23, dog. Yeah, KD 36, 35. Yeah, come on, man. There's no disrespect to Jamal. I don't know what you're trying to start, but yeah, not at all.
First, it's great audio. I'm finna turn 23.
Yeah.
I don't know what you're trying to start, man. And Sam Amick is great. And so I don't know if Anthony was actually, like, bothered by the line of questioning or whatever. But anyway, Jamal Murray. The Nuggets, they're largely built by people who are still in their 20s. And it just hit a certain way that Anthony Edwards, who right now, he looks like he might be about to make the jump from stardom to superstardom. It's a maybe. There are other candidates out there. The Celtics are fantastic, and I'd like everyone, I should have said to Steiny when he was pumping himself up about his Minnesota call in December. I told you all year that OKC, I thought, was going to go to the NBA Finals this year, and those young pups haven't lost a game yet. Very impressive performance last night, but I digress. Anthony Edwards has a shot to go from star to superstar. He has a shot to be talked about this offseason as the new one in the NBA, and he hasn't turned 23 yet.
Right.
And when he speaks about Kevin Durant, man, he's 35, 36. I grew up watching that guy. That's my guy. I look up to him. It's a compliment to Kevin Durant. As a Warrior fan, it felt different. It felt like Anthony Edwards is playing a game of dads versus kids over at the park, and the kids have finally grown up, and the kids are going to run circles around the dads, and the Warriors are made up of a bunch of dads. The Warriors are made up of the same type of people that Anthony Edwards was talking about in terms of Kevin Durant. And so we started thinking about this, and I wonder what your answer would be. If I'm Anthony Edwards, let's say I do win the NBA title this year. For the next 5 years of my career, I look around the league. Who am I worried about?
You're worried about a 25-year-old Shai Gilgeous-Alexander.
Okay.
A 25-year-old Luka Doncic.
Okay.
And a 26-year-old Jason Tatum.
Okay.
And Giannis is probably 30, so I'll keep him out of the group. Nikola Jokic is probably 26, 27 himself, although he looks like he's 35.
29.
Okay, so 29. He is a little bit older, but yeah. When you talk about the group of superstars who are 26 and under, that's who you're worried about. It's Tatum, Edwards, and Doncic as the big three, and Gilgeous-Alexander, the big four, all under the age of 26. You're not looking at Steph and Draymond and thinking, oh boy, the next 5 years. Now, the Warriors might still have a one-off in them.
Maybe.
But it's not going to be one of those things where you're worried about them in 2030.
Well,
none of these guys will probably be playing then.
Well, even if they do have a one-off in them, do we all agree it needs to have somebody else on the team with them?
Probably some youth and speed.
Don't you think?
Because you think about, forget Luka for this conversation, but Edwards is a blur. Gilgeous-Alexander is super quick.
Yep.
Tatum is very athletic, more athletic than anybody on the Warriors. So, yeah, it's not only age, it's also athleticism.
I mean, we've said it a bunch last few weeks, last few months. For me, the number this offseason is two. It's two. The Warriors need a two. By the way, that two better moonlight sometimes as a one.
Yeah.
But they need a two, and that needs to be the first number in his age.
Two. Yeah.
Two.
And I would also argue that they need two. They need two players. And assuming Chris is gone, sure. And also assuming that Clay signs elsewhere, probably Orlando, it would be great to get two players in. And the other piece of this, which makes me have to swallow hard and come to terms with the reality, one of your best athletes is a guy who I really, really want traded. So do you get more athletic when you trade Andrew Wiggins? You're probably not going to trade Wiggins and get two really good athletes for the price of one. So
I don't know. I
getting
don't know.
Rid of Wiggins makes you less athletic almost automatically, and that becomes hard for me to take. Because
I don't know. It depends. If
he is one of your best athletes.
Yeah, but if you're getting 20-somethings back, I get what you're saying.
Possibly.
The skill set for Andrew Wiggins is elite. He's the number one overall draft pick. That's the skill set. But what is athleticism that is used
at
70% right. speed? It's not the same level of athleticism. But anyway, this is not, I'm not drafting a point of like me being out on the idea of the Warriors' future or me being out on the idea of Steph Curry still being the centerpiece of a good team. That's not what I'm saying at all. What I am saying, though, is that, and a lot of people have felt this in a number of different directions, but when Anthony Edwards sits there and talks about all of these guys, Kevin Durant, Steph Curry, Klay Thompson, Draymond Green, anybody else, you know, you could throw LeBron into this conversation, Jimmy Butler, all of these stars who are either at or close to their 35th birthday or beyond, like, they're talking about them like the dads at the park. And when the kids, you know, when they come out of puberty, Dibs, they beat the dads because they're faster and they're better and they're stronger and they're more limber and athletic and all of these things. So that's kind of what got me thinking about the conversation we were just having on the changeover. Like, I hear it in a few spots, certainly not all of you, but I do hear it places. There seems to be this fear that if we don't freak out and do the right thing, Steph's going to get mad. And then he will demand a trade. And we know in the NBA, when the star says trade me, the star's in total control. And I was thinking about it today. I'm like, that person's never 37. That doesn't happen. There are a lot of guys in the NBA right now that the younger stars are not worried about anymore. They're not worried so much, even about LeBron. They're not worried about Kevin Durant. Anthony flicked them off. They're not worried as much about Steph, Clay, and Dre. They're not worried about Kawhi Leonard. They're not worried about Paul George. Is there a group that you could put together where those guys are part of a phenomenal team? Absolutely, I believe that. But none of them are that dude anymore. None of them are that dude.
It doesn't mean that he necessarily wants to play out his days here. If things aren't going the way that he wants from a roster structure standpoint.
But what does that even look like? The Warriors will be in control. He's under contract for two more years.
Right.
I don't think,
Talking about at the end of next year.
Right, so now...
So he would have 1 year left, and...
And 37.
If they're talking extension, and he can make it be known that he's not going to sign an extension and that he wants to play elsewhere.
And give me the NBA team that looks at that scenario and goes, all right, we are moving the house to acquire Steph Curry.
For 1 year? An expiring Steph Curry, the greatest shooter in the history of the game?
Yeah.
I would imagine there will be a team, or more than one team, who would be willing to part with whatever assets they need to part with. Probably not a lot of picks, but some players, maybe a pick, to bring a guy in who could get you over the top.
You're sort of presenting that a little bit differently. The Warriors are not trading Steph for, like, you know, you get some pieces. I mean, like, this is, again,
if he wants to be elsewhere.
He's the greatest person that's ever put a jersey on.
And I'm not saying this is a wild hypothetical, but if you play another season and you're not a playoff team again, and he gets to the point where he's got 1 year left in his deal, he might have a different perspective, especially if Clay's already gone and, you know, who knows where Draymond is and who knows what the team is doing. He might be in a spot where he wants to go somewhere and compete for a championship.
Right, but again, like, what does that even look like? No one's going to acquire Steph to be their one. So if he says, I want out of here, you're completely now headed in, if you're Steph, you're headed in a direction of, as you said it, you're going to be like the piece that puts somebody over the top, potentially.
As opposed to the guy who's carrying the water for a 41-11 seed, a 41-win 11 seed.
I think he wants to carry the water. That's the point.
Yeah, we don't know what it'll be like in a year.
I mean, if Steph Curry would like to fade into the background of a roster, he can go tell the Warriors that. And they'll gladly start moving things around and have Steph play 26 minutes a game.
I would guess he doesn't want to have another year like he had this year where his number one running mate was unavailable for a third of the season, and his other running mate was out there hunting his own shot.
Agreed.
And his other running mate was seldomly, consistently out there, and then the rest of the guys are 15 years his junior. I don't think that this was his idea of fun this year.
I agree with you, but I don't think that, again, what I'm trying to play out here in my mind is the reality that if it got to that, what does that even look like? Steph would be relinquishing basically everything. He would be relinquishing the keys to the car, the kingdom, the desire to never put on another jersey. He'd be leaving Draymond Green, who he has said he never wants to play without. Draymond has said it too. Steve Kerr has signed up for 2 more years. They're all kumbaya. They want to do this together. To me, the reason he's doing that is not only because it's been an incredibly enjoyable experience, but this is the only place left. It's the only place where Steph can play this role. He is not like acquiring Giannis right now. He's not like acquiring Joel Embiid. There's not going to be an organization that's like, okay, Steph's available. We're redoing the organization and building around him as our one. He's 37 years old and 185 pounds. Like that,
I don't think that matters.
Of course,
all
it
that
does.
Matters is what kind of a player is he. And you look at his fall off; it has been very, very slight this year to the previous years. He's still one of the 15 best players in the league
statistically, but he's not affecting winning like the top players do.
I would say that he is affecting winning at the same level, but
he
didn't have the same amount of help. Anthony Edwards has a better team than Steph does.
Right, but he's also affecting winning better. You can't argue that Steph Curry is affecting winning the same way that he used to. They're the 10 seed.
Right.
I mean,
with two rookies and a couple of third-year guys.